nice day today. It's about 80 degrees here in Los Angeles. You're obviously with Alex Vespucci representing.
We're with Vespucci.
Where's he at?
He's in the tent waiting for the weigh-ins.
Some of the fighters weighed in already earlier this morning. Lomachenko weighed in at 10. He made weight.
Everybody weighed.
Even Vespucci?
Yeah.
How much did he make weight when he weighed in?
147. This just for the TV.
Well, it's good. I think it's a smart move because for years the UFC would do this. When a guy's weighing at 10 a.m., then they can eat, relax, and then they don't have to start themselves till 4 p.m.
Yeah, this was originally the plan, weigh in here. But I don't know why they brought the weigh in early over there. Now everybody's here.
Where did you weigh in earlier? At the hotel? Was there anybody there or just commission?
Commission.
That's it.
Just the commission. It was clusterfuck because everybody weighed in. Where's Vespucci needs to come and weigh in? Where's the opponent? He already weighed in and left.
What? And they didn't know that? So you couldn't see the opponent if you weighed in?
The commission was there.
But you like to be there to observe?
It was
hectic.
It was no organization. But
it's a good concept, though, Mac. Yeah. I like the idea. Now, let's talk really quick. One of your fighters, Egas Kavalauskas, recently fought Ray Robinson. And everyone that I saw scored the fight as a win for Egas. What happened there with the judges?
Definitely it was a win. We won the fight. Why? At the most, if you want to give him some rounds to be nice, you can give him at least 2 rounds. But not because he connected more punches, just because he avoided more punches, but Egas connected more, powerful punches, threw more punches and everything. You know, it's just the hometown judges' decision.
Unfortunately.
We got a draw. Fortunately, they didn't give us a loss that would have been devastating, but you know, we're still in line, WBO number one, and we're hoping to get that proper fight.
Absolutely. So what happens, Crawford against Kavalauskas? First, Crawford has Amir Khan, which is a very tough fight.
Crawford has to take care of Amir Khan. Amir Khan's got experience. He's talented.
Fast hands.
Speed. You know, this is Crawford's third fight at welterweight.
Crawford's crazy talented, too. So.
Crawford's crazy talented, but it's his third fight at welterweight. Amir's been at welterweight for a minute already. This is Crawford's third fight at welterweight. He just beat Jose Benavidez on his last fight at 147. He looked good, sensational. So we're hoping for Crawford to win, and hopefully we can get that fight next.
And then that will be a huge fight, mega fight.
Yes.
Lithuania against USA.
Lithuania against USA, yes.
All right, Mac, where do people follow you if they're watching?
Mac Boxer, 19.
I saw you posted a picture of you and seven of your brothers, but three of your brothers look like identical twins. Are they twins?
I have four brothers, yeah. No, we're none of them. We're all 2 years apart.
You guys look alike.
We're all 2 years apart, except for the youngest. He was like 6 years apart, but everybody's like...
That's Jesus, right?
Yeah, Jesus is
What's he doing these days?
I don't know. He went to school. He's graduated and working. He might come to the fight. He wanted to come to the weigh-ins, but I told him don't even think about it. This is going to be...
It's hectic. Nixie Hustle Memorial next door. Yeah. More police here than I've ever seen.
Yeah, you got my friend from Lithuania.
How you feeling?
Support, doing well. Mean Machine fan.
Как дела?
Хорошо.
Нормально?
Нормально.
I see Chicago.
Chicago.
Chicago. Came to Chicago to support.
Разговоры, разговоры. Разговоры means words. Talk. Пока.
Пока. Ике. Всем Литвине.
Привет, привет. What do you say in Lithuania?
Ике.
Ике.
Ике. Ике.